Hello guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Daisy. This is our beginner Mandarin Chinese class, lesson 3. Since this lesson, we will start different topics. So this lesson, the topic is for greeting. Firstly, I will help you go through the whole conversation of greeting, just in case some of you guys only want to learn the sentence. Afterwards, we will learn each word and the sentence structure carefully. So now, let's start. This is the conversation we're gonna learn today. 你好 ,Hello. 你好 ,Hello. 我叫 Tom. 你叫什么名字 ?I'm to be called Tom. What's your name? 你好 Tom. Hi Tom. 我叫 Alex. I'm to be called Alex.我很高兴认识你。I'm very happy to know you. 我也很高兴认识你。I'm also very happy to know you. 下次见。See you next time. 好的，再见。All right, goodbye. Are you trying to find out where is how are you, right?But the truth is, how are you doesn't work in our daily life in China. So when we meet each other, we only say, 你好 ,hello, and then you reply me exactly the same thing. 你好 ,that's it, no how are you. There are 13 Chinese words and 3 sentence structures in this conversation. I will divide those 13 words into different word types like noun, adjective, blah blah blah. And after you go through those words with me one by one, you will realize you can speak more than your imagination. Let us start with personal pronoun. There are 2 personal pronouns in this conversation. The first one is 你你 means you. The second one is 我我means I or me. So now follow me. 你你我Alright, now let us move to the verb. So for verb, we also got 2. The first one is 叫叫叫 means to be called or to call. The second one is 认识认识认识 means to know. So now follow me. 叫叫认识认识 Alright, so now I will introduce you the most common sentence structure in Chinese that is also exactly the same with English, which is subject plus verb plus objects. So, for example, you say, I am Daisy. That is subject plus verb plus object, right? So now we already learned 4 words, so we can make some sentence. Use the 4 words we learned with this sentence structure. So I can say, 我叫 Daisy. I'm to be called Daisy. 你叫 Tom, right? Also, I can say, 我认识你 I know you. So for example, you already heard of me from your friends before you see me. So when you see me, you can say, Oh, I know you. You are Daisy. You can say, 我认识你你叫 Daisy, right? 我认识你你叫 Daisy. Yeah, you see, we only learned 4 words, but we can speak quite a few sentences now, right?Next one is adverbs. We also got 2. The first one is 很. 很 means very. Second one is 也. 也 means also as well. So now follow me. 很. 很. 也. 也. And then is adjectives. We also got 2.The first one is 好好 好 means good. The second one is 高兴。高兴。高兴 means happy. So now follow me, read it. 好。好。高兴。高兴。Alright guys, so did you realize when we say 你好你好 when we say hello to each other 你好你 we already learned it means you 好 is good actually when they say 你好 that means you good so now I will give you the second sentence structure of today this one is different with English so English has a sentence structure is subject plus verb plus adjective for example I say I'm happy right I, subject, I'm, verb, happy, adjective. But in Chinese, that doesn't work. We will use an adverb to connect the subject and adjective. So the sentence structure will be subject plus adverb plus adjective. So here, if you want to say, I'm very happy, 我很高兴我 subject 很 adverb 高兴 adjective you cannot put I'm inside here okay and also you may ask me oh Daisy you guys always say I'm very happy too if I'm not that happy I'm just a little bit happy or I'm just alright what should I do no worries okay we have different adverbs to say a little bit or extremely or a lot so no worries so today we just learn very the most common one we learned more than one adjective today right we also learned how means good so if you say I'm very good use this sentence structure you can say 我很好 right 我很好 if some Chinese ask youOh, how are you? Then you can use Chinese to reply them. 我很好，我很好 I'm very good. And also, did you remember? We just learned another adverb, which is 也 means also, right? So if you want to say, I'm also very happy. 我很高兴 That means I'm very happy. If you want to say, I'm also very happy, where should we put that also, that 也? We will put it.After subject, so I will say 我也很高兴 I'm also very happy, right? If in the sentence has more than one adverbs, like this sentence 我也很高兴 也 and 很, those two are both adverbs. You have to remember 也 is always the first adverb in a sentence. Now put a sentence in your mind.Which is 我很高兴我很高兴 means I'm very happy, right? So then we plus another two words we just learned it. First one, 认识认识 means to know. Second one, 你 means you. So we put those things together. 我很高兴认识你 That meansI'm very happy to know you. So in another words, nice to meet you, right? And when you reply them, you will say, I'm also happy to know you. Just like I said, we put 也 as the first adverb. That will be 我也很高兴认识你 That means I'm also happy to know you. So now follow me to read this long sentence together. 我也很高兴认识你 I'm also very happy to know you. The next word type is question word. Today we got one which is 什么什么 means what. Follow me read it. 什么什么For the question words, English and Chinese are same. So you guys have what to ask the normal objects, right? Mandarin, same. And you guys have when to ask time, who to ask a person, where to ask location, where, same. Today's lesson, we only learn what, 什么. The rest of the question words, we will learn in the future. So now I will give you the last sentence structure of this lesson, which is subject plus verb plus question words. So we can say 你叫什么? You call what kind of what is your name, right? What is your name? 你 subject 叫 verb 什么 question words 你叫什么? What's your name? So I can say 我叫 Daisy to reply you, right? 我叫 Daisy. I am Daisy or I'm to be called Daisy. So now follow me to read this conversation.你叫什么?你叫什么? What's your name? 我叫 Daisy. 我叫 Daisy. I'm to be called Daisy. The next one is a noun, which is 名字. 名字, which means name. So follow me, read it. 名字. 名字.So did you remember we just learned 你叫什么? That is in the casual way to ask them, oh, how could I call you in this feeling? If you want to ask them in the really formal way, you can say 你叫什么名字? 你叫什么名字? Same with 你叫什么? No difference, just the first one, 你叫什么?is more casual. Second one, 你叫什么名字? More formal. That's it. So now follow me, read it. 你叫什么名字? 你叫什么名字? So you can answer me your name like, oh, 我叫 Alex. Oh, 我叫 Tom. And then we left three phrases, which is 好的 means all right, great.When people ask your opinion, is that okay? You can answer them, 好的,好的, alright? Second one is, 下次见,下次见, which is see you next time. The last one is, 再见,再见, which is goodbye, goodbye. So those three, follow me to read it. 好的好的，下次见，下次见，再见，再见。Those three words, you can just understand it in the daily short phrases. Do not need to think too much for what's the grammar behind. Okay, so now, after we know all the words and all the sentence structures,Now let us go through the whole conversation again. 你好 Hello 你好 Hello 我叫 Tom I'm to be called Tom 你叫什么名字 What's your name? 你好 Tom Hi Tom 我叫 Alex I'm Alex我很高兴认识你。I'm very happy to know you. 我也很高兴认识你。I'm also very happy to know you. 下次见。See you next time. 好的。All right. 再见。Bye bye. All right, guys. That is all about today.All the words and the sentence structures that we go through today, you can find it in the description part of this video. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment or you can go to apply a free trial lesson with me. The link of how to book a free trial lesson, you can find it in the first line of this video description part. Okay, guys, 再见 bye bye. By the way, do not forget, subscribe to my channel.Or give me a like. I'm Daisy, I'm here to help you learning Chinese. 再见, bye bye!